Hello, my dear students. In the previous class, we have already discussed about listening. So, today let us more elaborately know what are the types of listening. Number one, passive listening. Number two, attentive listening. And number three, active or empathetic listening. What is passive listening? Passive listening is hearing what a person says without responding to them in any way. The person listening does not show any reaction to what they had heard. What is attentive listening? Attentive listening occurs when one is genuinely interested in the speaker's point of view. What is active listening? Active listening shows the speaker that you are concerned. Active listening leads to getting better information. Active listening requires definite intent to listen, focus on the speaker, verbal and non-verbal encourages. Feedback loop to ensure accuracy. Listening versus hearing. Hearing is the sense that allows you to perceive sound, physical act, only requires reception of sound waves. Listening, mental process that requires concentrating on sound, depriving meaning from it and reacting to it. Key points. Hearing is a physical act. Listening is an active mental process, attempt to make meaning of what we hear. Listening leads to learning, opens, encourages personal growth and learning. Importance of active listening. These are some of the important points we should remember. Active listening shows the speaker that you are concerned, leads to getting better information. Shows the speaker that you are concerned, leads to better information, encourages further communication. Potential to enhance relationships, calm down to upset person, invite others to listen to you, better cooperation and problem solving. Minimize misunderstandings, help us to learn more, help us to adapt and understand, key to success, avoid communication errors. Barriers to effective listening. Remember, half of the listening just after a day, 75% of what you heard is incorrect. 80% of time is spent on communicating during working hours and 45% is spent on listening. Adults only listen 25% effectively. Barriers to effective listening. Psychological limitation, inadequate background information, selective memory, selective perception, fear of being influenced or persuaded, bias and being judgmental, boredom, partial listening and distractions, rehearsing, selective perception, interference from emotions. Suggestions for effective listening. Ask questions if you don't understand completely. Avoid distraction. Use direct eye contact. Don't interrupt. Read both verbal and non-verbal messages. Be empathetic. Paraphrase to correct misinterpretations. Evaluate the message after hearing all the facts. Concentrate on the message as well as the messenger. Give feedback to check accuracy. Listen with your entire body. Don't talk so much. So now we shall do an exercise. I'll be reading a very short story and you have to listen. And after that you have to write what you have understood from the story. And you have to submit me the story after the class. So, the story goes this way. An old man lived in the village. He was one of the most unfortunate people in the world. The whole village was tired of him. He was always gloomy. He constantly complained and was always in a bad mood. The longer he lived, the more vile he was becoming and more poisonous were his words. People avoided him because his misfortune became contagious. It was even unnatural and insulting to be happy next to him. He created the feeling of unhappiness in others. But one day when he turned 80 years old, an incredible thing happened. Instantly everyone started hearing the rumor. An old man is happy today. He does not complain about anything, smiles, and even his face is freshened up. The whole village gathered together. The old man was asked, "What happened to you?" The old man replied, "Nothing special. 80 years I have been chasing happiness and it was useless. And then I decided to live without happiness and just enjoy life. That's why I'm happy now." Moral of the story, don't chase happiness, enjoy your life. So I think you have heard the story. Now your work is to write what you have understood from the story. Okay, so we shall discuss the stories which you have written after listening to it in our next class.